reminded him, "Dearest Mother, help us to avoid sin which separates us from our Heavenly Father and from one another. Full of trust in you, we place ourselves under the mantle of your maternal protection and confidently hope for your compassionate intercession. Amen." Prayer for the home. Mother of perpetual help, we choose you as queen of our homes. We ask you to bless all our families with your tender motherly love. May the sacrament of marriage bind husbands and wives so closely together that they will always be faithful to each other and love one another as Christ loves his church. We ask you to bless all parents. May they love and cherish the children whom God has entrusted to them. May they always give them the example of a truly Christian life. Help them to bring up their children in the love and fear of God. Bless all children that they may love, honor, and obey their fathers and mothers. To your loving care, we specially entrust the youth of today. Give us all a sense of responsibility that we may do our part in making our home a haven of peace like your own home at Nazareth. We take you as our model. Help us to grow daily in genuine love of God and neighbor so that justice and peace may happily reign in the entire family of mankind. Amen. Petitions to our Mother of Perpetual Help, Holy Mary, pray for us. Holy Virgin conceived without sin, pray for us. Our Mother of Perpetual Help, pray for us. We sinners call to you. Loving Mother, pray for us. That we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for men. Loving Mother, pray for us. That we may be more and more like our Divine Lord as you were. Loving Mother, pray for us. That we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son, Jesus. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may fear losing God's friendship forever by unrepented sin. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may see Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of daily life. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in moments of temptation. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may understand the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may grow in the love of Christ and neighbor by frequent communion. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may strive to be true Christians by our loving concern for others. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may forgive from our heart those who have wronged us. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may see the evil of seeking our own interests at the expense of others. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may share our talents with others for the good of the community. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may accept our responsibility in the community in a spirit of genuine service. Loving Mother, pray for us, that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and the clergy. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be blessed with an increase in priestly and religious vocations. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may care and protect God's creation. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may defend the human dignity and sanctity of human life from conception to natural death. Loving Mother, pray for us, that there will be genuine and lasting peace in the world. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know Him. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be aware of our dependence in God in the midst of human achievements. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father. Loving Mother, pray for us, that we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord. Loving Mother, pray for us, that our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection. Loving Mother, pray for us. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions. Holy Mary, pray for us. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience God's perpetual help. Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to have recourse to her in all our needs. Amen. Thanksgiving Prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, truly present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. It has pleased the Father that in you all his fullness should dwell, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we may be truly sorry for our sins and renew our lives. Through you, we thank the Eternal Father for the gift of life. He has created all the wonderful things of this world for us. May we learn to use them well, so that through them, we may grow in love for him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of his love, to save us and all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own mother to be our mother of perpetual help. May the countless favors we have received through her intercession, and especially through the novena, inspire us with greater confidence in God's loving mercy and her perpetual help. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God and persevere in his love. To the Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be honor, glory, and thanksgiving forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, you bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows in order to show us clearly the value of human weakness and patience. Graciously hear our prayer for the sick. Grant that they who are weighed down with pain and other afflictions of illness may experience God's healing power and comfort. Restore them to health in body and soul so that they can continue to serve you and their brothers and sisters. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good afternoon. Today is Wednesday of the 29th week in Ordinary Time. Our priest presider is Reverend Father Andy Ortega Lim. Please all stand.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ.
Good afternoon, Father.
Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as God's family, with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness, for He is full of gentleness and compassion. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I have written briefly earlier. When you read this, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which was not made known to human beings in other generations, as it has now been revealed to His holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this I became a minister by the gift of God's grace that was granted me in accord with the exercise of His power. To me, the very least of all the holy ones, this grace was given to preach to the Gentiles the inscrutable riches of Christ, and to bring to light for all what is the plan of the mystery hidden from ages past in God who created all things, so that the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known through the Church to the principalities and authorities in the heavens. This was according to the eternal purpose that He accomplished in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness of speech and confidence of access through faith in Him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and He has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim His name. Among the nations, make known His deeds. Proclaim how exalted is His name.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Sing praise to the Lord for His glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. Please all rise to honor the Holy Gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Stay awake, for you do not know when the Son of Man will come. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let this house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed it is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come on an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will but did not make preparations nor act in accord with his will shall be beaten severely. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. The Gospel reminds us first that we are simply stewards or caretakers of God. And second, it reminds us to be responsible. These two things. That's why Jesus gave his apostles a parable or a story about the steward who was responsible and a steward who may not be responsible or irresponsible. Both has consequences. Dun sa responsable, more has been entrusted to that person. And to the irresponsible steward, everything that has been entrusted will be taken away from the person. First, it's good to be reminded that we are simply caretakers. Maybe we own something in this world, but I guess it is right to say we cannot absolutely own something, because time will come, whether we like it or not, we have to let go. Pag dumating na yung oras mo, kahit anong kapit mo, wala kang magagawa. We always hear this saying, laban lang. Laban lang. Kaya mo yan, you will survive. Pero may hangganan. And those instances, they are reminders that we are simply caretakers. When we lose someone, it's so painful. When we lose something, it is painful. Masakit mawalan ka ng negosyo, trabaho. Masakit mawalan ka ng mahal sa buhay. But if we are reminded that we are simply caretakers, stewards, baka hindi masyado masakit. Kasi pinagkatiwala lang sa atin. Kaya tama yung awit sa Pilipino, hiram sa Diyos ang ating buhay. Hiram lang naman sa Diyos. And if you are simply stewards, caretakers, let us make use of what God has entrusted to us, not to abuse, not to misuse, but to make use of what God has given us. And ang una, and we pray to Jesus, may we be good stewards. A second is, a steward is not only a caretaker. A steward should also be responsible. This is my reflection. Responsible is being having the ability to respond. Our responsibility, the ability to respond. Hindi ka nagbabantay. Habang nagbabantay ka, baka may mga sira, inaayos mo. Hindi ka na nagbabantay. Habang nagbabantay ka, nag-ilinis ka din. The ability to respond. Hindi ka na nagdadasal na maging mabuti ka. Nagdadasal, matapos ka magdasal, gumagawa ka ng mabuti. You respond. Having that ability to respond. Kaya responsibility. Yan, may responsibility ka. You have the ability to respond. May dapat kang gawin. And we are not simply stewards. We must be responsible. And again, we pray for that grace. Not only being good stewards, but being good and responsible stewards. Not only baptized Christians, but responsible Christians. Please rise for the prayers of the faithful. We place our faith in God the Father as we present before Him the needs and concerns of our lives. For every petition, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may always show deep faith in God who guides world events, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders and workers may be honest in their work and that they may always be ready to give an account of their work, not only before the people but before God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may be assiduous in their work and studies and keep on hoping for a better world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying may look to Christ with hope and penitent trust. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may enjoy forever the fullness of God's saving power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us include in our prayers the thanksgiving and petitions offered in this Mass. For those celebrating their birthday anniversaries, may God bless them. And for those who are sick, that God may heal them. Especially Mother Maria, Brother Rolly, Brother Pancho, and all those who are sick. And for the repose of all the souls, especially the souls of Celidonia, Brother Marcel Mary Angleo, Father Claro, Nomer, Chito. And in the silence of our hearts, let's offer to God all our prayers and petitions. Lord, in your wisdom, you know the hour and the day. Do not let our cares close our hearts to your coming. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Kunin at tanggapin ang alay na ito, mga biyayang nagmula sa pagpapala mo. Tanda ng bawat pusong pagkatinibig mo, ngayon'y nananalig, nagmamahal sa'yo.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming in glory, we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the scriptures you pray, descending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time, was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For it is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that we have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, ye may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Broderick, our administrator, all the bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz and companions, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together let us sing the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, he may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, may peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are invited to receive you.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
kapayapa at pagkakaisa. Ang rosaryo kong hawak namin na awit-awit ang Ave Maria. Puspas ka ng diwang pangal, lingkin ang aming payak na dasal. Ihatid mo kami sa langit ng Amang mapagmahal. Jesus, puso namin ay ihahandog. Ang rosaryo mong hawak namin at awit-awit ang Ave Maria. Puspos ka ng diwang banal, dinggin ang amin.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Salamat po sa inyong pag-iisa sa ating banal na misa, and din sa mga patuloy na sumusubaybay sa ating Facebook live streaming. And please subscribe sa ating YouTube channel, Minor Basilica of San Lorenzo Ruiz. By Saturday, we will start our novena for all the souls. And in the whole month of November, we will pray for all the souls in a special way. Para po sa inyong mga pamisa, para sa kaluluwa, pakihulog po dyan sa white box para maisama sa ating daily masses and blessings. Salamat. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mabuting hapon po sa inyong lahat.